back in business. The hour was up. I'm gonna work on this part a little bit. The edge on this side is actually lighter. This bottom area is lighter too. The hour went up really fast this time. Let's get this pit. I'm gonna get this shadow in. Oops, too light. There's variation in the shadow too. It is also not just one color. Like in focus mode. fix up these shadows here. Some pretty dark shadows down here. And they get darker as they get closer to the object. Same with down here. I'm gonna tie in some of that and darken the shadow here. And do the same for the knife shadow. Clean my palette again. Oh, yes, this is gouache. Sergio Lopez, aka Main Loop, had the good idea of kind of writing down some frequently asked question answers and putting it up there, but I haven't done that yet. Next time. Getting there. I think I've got maybe what 30 minutes to go. The avocado interior isn't even really green. It's more just like this yellow, orange. I actually watched a YouTube video prior to this on how to cut an avocado. And that's how I so masterfully did it. The paper that I use is Arches. This is specifically cold press Arches paper. Thank you, MJ. Yeah, I might need to work on the light still. I'm not quite finished with doing all that. I'll probably give everything one more pass. I've mainly been focusing on the shadows right now. My avocado's starting to brown a little bit. I'll be honest, I kind of like it. It's bringing in some cool or interesting colors. Has a bit of this kind of dimply skin. I have a pretty full palette right now. It's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh, I think it's 17. I almost filled the entire thing. There's a couple of colors that I rarely use. I have this really bright purple and bright pink that I only use if I'm painting really saturated flowers. I try to limit the use because the light fastness of those colors in particular aren't as strong. I need to work on this shadow, don't I? Pretty dark. It's cooler as it goes down. I'm gonna add a little more blue to this side. There we go. Now for the knife. I have not touched this knife hardly at all. It's kind of grayed down slightly. I don't want it to be super saturated blue. Oops. And it's a pretty flat color. It's not a ton of variation. But there is a little bit. I'll probably go into the shadow and straighten that up a little bit. Slipping off. These handles are pretty worn. They're kind of grayed out in some spots. Bit of shadow here in the knife. Okay. not as talkative in this one. I apologize. It's hard to be talkative and everything. It helps if you guys ask questions, but there's no pressure. We don't need to have a full-on conversation either. I'm gonna go in to this pit area. And I could just leave it, but I kinda like this space. There's a little bit of space around the pit. I want to add some of these holes that I'm seeing in the bread. Of course, I'm not going to go in and draw each individual hole. And I don't want all of them to even be in there. I want to give hints at the texture. Actually gonna have to go and lighten these up a bit. It's hard to tell what the values are gonna be when it dries. But I wanna err on the lighter side for these. I don't want them to be too distracting. And we're gonna go the same for this side. I'm glad it makes you happy. Alright, I'm gonna... It's a little darker and a little cooler down here, just like how the bread is. And then we're gonna carry it right through. To in here. You can barely see them right now, but I think they're gonna end up being darker. Hope anyway. Yep, this is a flat. I almost exclusively work in flats. in this bread here. I don't want that to touch that. I'm gonna go in, lighten this. I don't know. I'm not saying that everyone should be just using flats. I just think they're pretty, like, you can do a lot of strokes with them. And since I do a lot of plein air painting, I like to pack as light as I can. So carrying as few brushes as possible is nice. But I have been using this round lately, which is pretty nice. And I always have this Kolinsky round that looks pretty bent out of shape, but I use these two. I use this one for the fine details, and it's a good signature brush. Oh, the puppies are mad. They've been out there all day. Poor things. This one? I honestly don't know. I have worn off all the writing on it, but I'm guessing it's a 1. Maybe a 2. So I'm almost done here. There's a couple of little spots that I want to fix and some values that I want to fine tune. So I am just cleaning off my palette, probably for the last time. Happy Friday to those that are working 9 to 5s. Sitting at your desk, escaping reality. That used to be me. Okay. Last bits. I'm gonna go over here and here again, kind of crisp up the shadows. And I wanna work a little bit more on the cutting board. Some nice reds in here. Now that the light is a little more how it was when I started, I'm just going through and tweaking some of the colors. Oops. Oh, thank you. Kind of just giving everything a final pass. bit darker and muted. Hello, Sun Art. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much. You know, there's actually quite a few on YouTube because I've been kind of going down that rabbit hole of looking at all the other gouache tutorial videos. And there's a lot out there. It's becoming pretty popular recently, which I'm kind of, it's bittersweet. It's good to see other people using it and trying it out, but then all my supplies are always being sold out. I never had a problem before with gouache, but now all my favorite colors are always on hold or on wait. Be a bit of a perfectionist, which is kind of a fault. But I really want to straighten this line out. There, huh? Sorry, I keep hitting the phone. I'm not used to it being there. Welcome. Thank you for watching. One annoying part is that I always get paint on my pinky. And then, as you probably noticed, I kind of carry it all the way around the painting. So annoying. Then I have to touch stuff up. And if you've ever worked in gouache, you know how annoying it is to touch stuff up. It's so hard to get the exact color that you had. I'm gonna lighten some of these up slightly. Standing out a little too much. I wanted to soften that highlight a bit. And make it a little bit brighter. I think that's about it. I usually kind of noodle around for a little bit after, but I'm about to call it done. darken this side a little bit. I still want to get a little bit of this blue. All right. I'm going to call it done. I think I'll probably be tweaking a little bit, maybe on this knife handle, but I don't want to bore everyone. So thank you for watching. It was fun. I will be posting this on Instagram TV or whatever it's called, and also YouTube. So be sure to check it out. It'll also be in my stories. Special thanks to anyone that started a conversation or asked any questions. Thank you.